Hey everyone, thanks so much for coming back to my channel for another video. Today, we are gonna be talking about something obviously super important. And if you clicked on this video, you probably do struggle with this, as I know I do and have, you know, pretty much my whole life, and that's self-trust. And I think everybody sort of goes through a time in their life when they do struggle with this. And you know, I've kind of come to the conclusion that self-trust is honestly probably one of the biggest pillars of self-confidence. If you don't trust yourself, how can you really make, you know, decisions that are best for you? Because ultimately, you are the only one who truly knows what's best for you. And yes, we have people in our lives who love us, who you know, always want to see us do well and to see us, you know, be our best. But, you know, whether that be your parents, your friends, your siblings, your significant other, whatever the case may be, they are not you. Therefore, they don't truly know. They don't know everything that you know about yourself. Truly, and they cannot be the best judge of what's going to be best for you in any given case. And you know, yes, I do believe in, you know, speaking with your friends and your family and your loved ones, and you know, like I just said, they typically do have your best interest in mind. But you know, always having to, this is my problem actually, always reaching out to friends to see, you know, oh, you know, this is my problem, what do you think I should do? Or, you know, reaching out to your parents, this is what I'm going through, what do you think I should do? I don't know how to solve this problem, and oh my gosh, this thing in my life, and you know, I don't know this and I don't know that. When the truth is, you know, we actually have all the answers inside of us, and fear is what holds us back. And a lack of self-trust and fear is what holds us back from taking full control of our lives and saying, look, you know, it doesn't feel good to me. You know, whatever the situation, whatever the circumstance, it either doesn't feel good, you know, to be here, you know, or to be with this person, or, you know, to do this thing. I'm not happy, but you know, and there may be other reasons why. There's always a reason why we do what we do, and there's always a reason why we stay in situations that may or may not be bad for us. But the point of, you know, trusting yourself and having self-trust is to be an intuitive person. Listen to your body in all areas of life, even if it's just as simple as, gosh, I always feel funny whenever I eat cheese. You know, that is something that your body is trying to tell you, look, this is not for us. This is not for me. You know, for whatever reason. And then of course that's like a, you know, health issue or whatever, but even if it's just something as simple as that, or it's something, you know, a little bit deeper, like, gosh, you know, you know, I really love this person that I'm with in this relationship, and we have all these memories together, and we have all of these, you know, beautiful things in common, and you know, they're a great person, but gosh, I don't know what it is that's itching at me, that something just doesn't feel right, something just feels off, and maybe you can't quite put your finger on it. You have to do a little bit more self-reflection and dig a little bit deeper into it, but don't brush that off. Those thoughts, those feelings, those intuitive moments that we have when we are alone, when we are in our own thoughts, those mean something. They are not just silly, oh, just brush it off, oh, it's no big deal. You know, and I think we've all probably been guilty of dismissing our you know, our gut feelings and our intuitive thoughts and things that we just knew in the back of our mind were, you know, there, you know, like, this could be a problem, or you know, I don't really know, I just don't have a good feeling about this. And we brushed it off, we put it to the wayside. We didn't bother with it because everybody else seemed okay, or nobody else, you know, was making a big issue about it or raising it as an issue at all. So we dismiss ourselves, we dismiss our feelings, we dismiss our thoughts, we dismiss our intuitive, just our intuition and our gut feelings in general, what our mind, body, and soul, you know, are trying to guide us, and we mess up. And what do you always say when that happens? Like, we've all been in a situation, several probably, where that has happened, where we knew it. We just knew it, but. We just knew, but. You know? And it's that but. It's that self-doubt. That thinking that, you know, someone else has more of an idea on what's best for you than you do. Listening to what other people have to say as opposed to listening to, you know, what you know in your heart and in your mind and your soul and all of that, you know, is telling you. And I've absolutely, like I just said, I mean, I've been saying the whole video, we've all made this mistake. And, you know, I can just think of countless times in my life when, you know, this has happened to me. And I think this year especially, I have been working on that with myself. You know, just really paying attention to how I feel about things. And in my journey of just, you know, self-love and self-appreciation and acceptance and all of these things, I think self-trust has to be included in that, because, you know, you have to be able to trust yourself first and foremost, and trust God. But as far as people on this earth, trust yourself, trust what you know you're feeling, what you know is right, and what you know is best for you, before you start going to other people trying to get their opinions, their thoughts. Oh, what should I do? Oh my gosh, I don't know. This and that and this and that. Like, I go back and forth and I teeter-totter in my mind, going back and forth between what I know is right and what I know I'm supposed to do, or what I think I'm supposed to do according to whatever society standards are, or according to what other people will think, or according to what everyone else is doing, or according to, you know, whatever I need to do to keep up an appearance, you know. And I'm just so past that now. I'm so past that. And I just, you know, I've had several experiences so far now in my life, in my 23 years of living, that have just proved this to be completely, you know, wrong, you know, and have just sort of forced me. I've had situations that have forced me literally to take a hard look at my life and take a hard look in the mirror and say, this is not for you. This is not your bliss. You know, how is this serving you? And why are you doing something that is, you know, taking away from you and not benefiting you, that you know in your heart of hearts is not making you happy, is not benefiting you, is not going to lead to anything, you know, is not going to lead to anything that you want anyways. So why are you doing it? And, you know, why are you allowing certain things and certain people in your life to just eat away at you? And I know that that's getting real deep, guys, but, you know, truly, even with yourself, just, you know, when you go back and forth, and like I said before about keeping up appearances or doing what other people, you know, think you're supposed to be doing or, you know, expect you to do, I mean, that can get really, really toxic as well. This whole thing that we have usually that's built up in our minds of expectations that, you know, are being placed on us by, you know, the world, our friends, our family, society, your Facebook feed, your Facebook friends, I don't know, you know, and we think, oh, well, you know, even if it's just subconsciously, like, this is what I'm supposed to be doing because this is what everybody my age is doing, or, you know, and if I trail off, even if I feel like, you know, I shouldn't be marrying this guy, or I shouldn't be with this guy, or if I think, oh my God, this job is not for me, and I'm really, really unhappy, but I can't leave because what will people say, you know? Sometimes we can almost feel trapped in our own minds, and it's not anybody else that's putting that on us. It's truly, it's built up in our own minds, because the truth is, there are people everywhere in the world that have, you know, lived their lives however they've wanted to live their lives. And once you truly come to a place of true love and true self-acceptance and learn how to trust yourself, you don't worry about any of that. You don't worry. You're at a place where you're just beyond that. You're above that. You're focused on you. Your top priority is you. It's not what everybody else thinks. It's not what everybody else is doing. It's not what they're gonna think of you. It's about what you're doing. Is what you're doing fulfilling you? Is it making you happy? Do you feel in your heart and in your gut and in your truly in your body and in your soul and in your mind that this is the right situation for you? That this is the right job you should be in, relationship you should be in? Are you getting everything that you need? Are you getting what you want in life, in this situation, in this friendship, in this, you know, town that you're living in, you know, hanging out with these people? So many things, guys. So basically that's the message of this video, and I just wanted to get this out because I've been loving, you know, having conversations with you guys, vlog style on my channel, and hopefully, you know, you've been able to get something from it. These are just, you know, it's just me sitting down on my couch, chatting with you guys and talking about, you know, things that are really important and things that I think kind of need to be talked about, and, you know, things that I'm going through, things that you're going through. And we're all working together, and we're all, you know, taking steps to just become better in life and, you know, in love and self-love. I think that's just, that's a real core value in my life. And so naturally, that's also just a really core, I guess, piece of content that's going to be coming on my channel. So yeah, I try to mix it up and do different things here and there, but I really love just sitting down, chatting with you guys, doing vlog style videos. I'm missing my tea today, guys. I'm actually probably gonna make a cup anyway. I just had some coffee not too long ago, so I wasn't really feeling the tea, but I should have, just to kind of get this whole like coffee, tea time, like ambiance thing. You know how the YouTubers do, you know, and I am a YouTuber, so I guess I should jump on the train. I drink coffee and tea anyway, anytime. But yeah, okay, that was random. Anyway, guys, all right, thanks so much for watching, and I hope you're able to get something out of this video. Leave a comment below, tell me about, you know, a situation that you've went through where, you know, or your journey in self-love and learning to trust yourself and what you've learned about that, and just, you know, share your experiences. I would love, love, love to read some comments, so post them down below, and let's talk about it, because this is important and we absolutely need to be at least improving, you know, on this, each and every one of us, because if you don't, I truly think that, you know, that's not a part of living your best life, you know, and that's what we're all trying to do, right? You know, 2018, live your best life. Anyway, all right, guys. So I will talk to you in the next video. Thanks again. Bye.